What's up everyone, Rafal here with OPT, and in this video we're going to be going over the ZWO ASI 174 and all the reasons why you may want one. The 174 is definitely one of the best cameras on the market when it comes to lunar, solar, and planetary photography, and it's time to explain why. But first, as always, if you guys are enjoying these videos and don't want to miss out on all the astro news, gear reviews, and OPT announcements, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, and ring the bell for notifications. And also, if you guys are enjoying this content, go ahead and smash the like button because it really does make a difference and lets us know that you guys are enjoying it. And with all that out of the way, let's dive into this amazing camera. So this is the ZWO ASI 174. This camera comes in two different versions, the standard version and the mini version. Now the standard and the mini version are both monochrome cameras, so you are gonna need filters when using them. The biggest difference between the standard and the mini is that the standard has a USB 3.0 port, which enables you to transfer data much faster on your computer. This comes in handy when you're doing lucky imaging and taking a high frame rate video of your targets. The ASI 174 can take up to 164 frames per second at a full 1936 by 1216 resolution, or you can set the camera to use only a fraction of the sensor to capture your image at a whopping 397 frames per second at 640 by 480. At that point, you're taking such a high frame rate that you're going to be creating a lot of data that needs to be saved in a short amount of time, hence the USB 3.0 port. Now, the mini version does not have a USB 3.0 port, so the takeaway here is that if you are wanting to use this camera as an imaging camera and as a guide camera, then we recommend you go with the standard version. But if you just want to use it as a guide camera, then the mini is the way to go. Now, like I mentioned earlier, since both versions of this camera only come in monochrome, you're going to want to get yourself a filter wheel and some filters if you want a full color image of the moon or planets. All right, let's talk some camera specs. Due to this being a planetary camera, it's got a smaller than average sensor. Like Mac mentioned in the Understanding Camera Specs video, a big sensor on a planetary camera is just not necessary. You'll end up getting a ton of information of stuff that you don't need, like the blackness of space. A smaller sensor gives you a faster frame rate due to the smaller resolution and smaller files. If you guys want to see Mac go into more details and other camera specs, check out the full video right up here. You do get a pretty impressive 12-bit 2.3 megapixel camera with a nice big 5.86 micron pixel size. The 174 does have a 77% quantum efficiency, which is higher than the majority of planetary cameras. This camera also has low read noise and a good size full well depth, giving you really good noise control and dynamic range. Now, whether you get the standard or the mini, both are amazing as guide cameras. With its big pixels and 70% quantum efficiency, it makes the Sony IMX174 sensor extra sensitive to light, making it perfect for picking up those faint stars. Now, you can totally use this camera for deep space imaging if you want to, and it'll do the job. But if you want our opinion, for that, we would recommend a few other cameras with a much bigger resolution, cooling, and overall built for deep space. You can see our top camera picks for Galaxy and Nebulae by clicking on the video right up here. When you get your ASI 174, it will come with a 1¼-inch thread, an SD4 cable, a USB cable, depending on which one you get, whether it's the mini or the standard, a lens cap, and a quick guide. And with all that said and done, that about wraps it up for this video. Like I said, everyone, the ZWO ASI 174 is an incredible piece of gear, whether it is a guide camera or an imaging camera. If you guys found this video helpful, go ahead and just completely obliterate that subscribe button, dig through the rubble, find the notification bell, and ring it. Because we have videos coming out every week, and we want you guys to be the best astronomers you can be. And of course, smash that like button to show your support for these videos, because it really lets us know that you guys are enjoying the content. Last but not least, if you have any questions, concerns, or suggestions on what topics we should cover next, leave them in the comments below, because Mac reads every single one of them. Isn't that right, Mac?
They just keep coming!
Thanks again for watching, everyone. My name is Rafal with OPT, and we'll see you in the next video. Clear skies.
I haven't slept in 3 days.